एवरीवन, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर सुगंधा कंगार वाघ, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, महात्मा फुले आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड सीताराम जी चौधरी साइंस महाविद्यालय वरुड। दिस सेशन इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द एक्सरसाइज ओनली, दैट इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस यूनिट, दैट इज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स एंड मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन, शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन एंड लॉन्ग आंसर क्वेश्चन। नाउ बिफोर we see the exercise, first we will see what we have studied earlier. Earlier here we have already studied the structure of earth, that is in structure of earth there is introduction of earth, then the internal structure of earth also, then the part of earth as a planet, and in these also there is introductory part, then atmosphere, lithosphere, the hydrosphere, composition of atmosphere. So here we have fully studied about the earth atmosphere. Now next part that we have studied as a earthquake, in earthquake also we have studied introductory part, then causes of earthquake, then terminologies associated with earthquake, types of earthquake, scale of intensity of earthquake, recording of earthquakes and all. And I have posted various videos on my YouTube channel as a Sugandha Kangar. So you can search all these videos related to all these topic, that is the structure of earth, internal structure of earth, part of earth as a planet, then the earthquake on my YouTube channel. Also we have studied the radiation in the atmosphere. I also posted one again video on YouTube channel, and also took all these LMS lectures. In radiation in the atmosphere, propagation of energy through vacuum, intensity of radiations, scattering, absorption, reflection of solar radiation by atmosphere, moisture and cloud, that was my last lecture we have studied yesterday, that is of on 7th September. Now see the exercise in your copy, in the syllabus this exercise is given related to the topic, what is atmosphere. See here, these are the short answer questions. You can study hard these questions. Answer is also mentioned in this slide. What is atmosphere? Atmosphere is the gaseous layer surrounding the earth. Short answer question means that question can be asked for 1 mark. You know very well. Then second question is, what is weather? So what is weather? See here, weather is an instantaneous physical condition of atmosphere. You can search all these questions from the YouTube videos, earlier YouTube videos. Now come towards the climate. What is climate? It is the weather condition experienced in any location over the long period of months, or it is a statistical average of day-to-day weather conditions. Now come towards fourth question. What are records? Its answer is, the solid part that makes the crust of earth is known as rocks. See here, fourth question, what are rocks, not records, huh? So its answer is the solid part that makes the crust of the earth is known as rocks. Now this is one more important question. Why ozone layer is called as an umbrella of earth? So its answer is also written here in this slide. Since the ozone layer absorbs harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun and protect life present on the earth. Why it is called as umbrella? Why ozone layer is called as umbrella of earth? Because the ozone layer absorbs all harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun and protect life present on the earth, protect us which we are present on the earth. Now what is ionosphere? See here, so the answer is given, it is the region above earth's surface which extends from 80 km to 500 km and contains positively charged particles, free electrons, and neutral particles such as neutrons. The electron density of this region is very high. This layer acquires a property to reflect electromagnetic waves and transmit it from the Earth. So in this way, these are the short answers questions and short answers questions, and you can read it very carefully as your examination coming soon in November month most probably. Now come towards seventh question. What is magnetosphere? The layer at about 2000 km above the Earth's surface is called as magnetosphere, and only electron and protons are present in this layer. The distribution of this particle is governed by magnetic field of the Earth and not by gravity. What is Van Allen belt? At about, now see here, Van Allen belt, that is new for us. All of us, we have studied in last two or three lectures. So at about 4000 km and 20000 km, 4000 km to 20000 km, the charged particles are concentrated. These zones are called as Van Allen radiation belt. See here, the region which is spread over the 4000 km to 20000 km. Where the charged particles are concentrated is called as Van Allen belts. What are the constituents of hydrosphere? The constituents of the hydrosphere are the sea and ocean water, rivers and lakes, ice, snow, frozen water and glaciers, groundwater which is in the cracks of the rock of the crust of the Earth. Now what is lithosphere? See this, lithosphere is a solid part of Earth which includes crust and uppermost part of mantle. Then come towards hydrosphere. Hydrosphere is a common name for all natural water sources on the Earth and below the surface of the Earth. Then what is earthquake? Come towards earthquake. This sudden minor or major shocks recorded by Earth's surface is known as earthquake. The sudden minor or major shocks recorded by Earth's surface, that is crust, is known as earthquake. Now the question number 13 is, define focus of an earthquake. The focus of an earthquake is the exact point of origin of earthquake below the surface of Earth. See, the focus of earthquake is? The focus of earthquake is exact point of origin of an earthquake below the surface of Earth. Define epicenter of an earthquake. Epicenter is the point on the surface of Earth vertically above the focus of an earthquake. Now see here, question number 15. What are seismic waves? Elastic waves which are generated from the focus of earthquake are called as seismic wave. Then question number 16 is, what is seismoscope? A seismoscope is a device which indicates the occurrence of earthquake but not write record. What is seismoscope? Seismoscope is a device which indicates the occurrence of an earthquake but not write record is called as seismoscope. Now come towards seismograph. What is seismograph? These are short answer questions, but these are very useful. Seismograph is an instrument which writes a permanent continuous record of earth motion. What is seismogram? The continuous record of seismic shocks recorded by seismograph are known as seismogram. What is tsunami? Now come towards that word you have heard gradually. When earthquake occurs in the ocean floor,
Very large water waves are produced on the surface of ocean. These waves are known as tsunami. It means coastal waves, means these occurs in the coastal areas, that is the sea areas. What is scattering? The process of spreading the incident radiation in all directions due to presence of small particle in the is known as scattering. What is scattering? Scattering means spreading, simply spreading. Spreading the radiations in all directions. That is the process of spreading the incident radiations in all directions due to presence of small obstacle particles in its path is known as scattering. What is absorption? Absorption is a process in which part of incident radiation is retained and converted into the other form of energy such as heat. What is absorption? Absorption is a process in which part of incident radiation is retained and converted into other form of energy known as heat. Now come towards reflection, that is very easiest definition. That phenomena is very much easy to understand and we have studied frequently. Reflection is a process in which part of incident radiation on striking a body turns in the same media is known as reflection. What is reflection? It is the process in which the part of incident radiation on striking a body is known and turns into the same media is known as reflection. Now what is moisture? We have heard this word frequently, many times, daily, regularly we can say moisture. How to define moisture here? So see this question number 23 now. Moisture means the given air volume contains some amount of water vapor. The given air volume contains some amount of water vapor. Define clouds. Clouds means what? As we will see, the clouds daily in the sky. Clouds can be defined as the mass of droplets or ice particle suspending in atmosphere. Clouds can be defined as a mass of droplets or ice particle suspending in atmosphere. Now, see this question. There may be such question in your question paper. Select correct alternatives. See here. Means multiple choice question, we can say, like a MCQs. So see, first question, such type of question can be asked on this unit. The Earth's interior region, which is a source of much volcanic activity, is known as, we have these four options, that is the crust, mantle, core and all of these. So what is interior region which is a source of much volcanic activity? Mantle. See here, it is highlighted. Then the Earth interior region, which is rich of silica, is called as the first region, that is the interior region, is called as crust. A region of the Earth which is believed to be made up of iron and nickel is known as, see here, core. But for this, I solve all the questions. But for this, you should refer my videos. I will also post the notes of this unit after completion of whole activity. That is, maybe in next week. Uniform decrease in temperature with increase in height, that is altitude, takes place in a troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere. Uniform decrease in temperature with increase in height takes place where? In which sphere? So here it is in troposphere. Much of the total atmospheric ozone contained in troposphere or stratosphere or mesosphere or in thermosphere, it happens in the stratosphere. Much of the total atmospheric ozone contained in stratosphere. Harmful ultraviolet radiations will be absorbed by the layer of, which layer absorb harmful ultraviolet radiations? As it is the common question, it is well known question. The ozone layer absorb harmful ultraviolet radiations. The most of the meteorological phenomena like cloud, rain, lightning occur within the height of 10 kilometer or 20 kilometer or 30 kilometer or 40 kilometer. For this, you should refer my previous videos. So here, the most of the meteorological phenomena like cloud, rain, lightning occur within the height of 30 kilometer. The gas whose volume percentage increases with height is known as which gas? Nitrogen gas, oxygen gas, ozone gas or argon gas? Here ozone. The gas whose volume percentage increases with height is known as ozone gas. The layer of atmosphere adjacent to the earth's surface is called as mesosphere or ionosphere or troposphere or stratosphere. Now see, troposphere is highlighted here. The layer of an atmosphere adjacent to the earth's surface is known as troposphere. The atmosphere can be divided into homosphere and heterosphere on the basis of their temperature with height, B is the electrical properties, C is the gaseous composition, and none of these. Now see here, the gaseous composition is very much important. Atmosphere can be divided into exosphere, magnetosphere, ionosphere and Van Allen radiations belts on the basis of options are given here. The temperature with height, electrical properties, then the gaseous composition and none of these. So from this, electrical property is the option of this question. Then the atmosphere can be divided. Then the atmosphere can be divided into troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere and thermosphere. Thermosphere on the basis of temperature. Option A is temperature with height, electrical properties, gaseous composition and none of these. So temperature with height is mentioned here. In troposphere with height or altitude, temperature increases or decreases or remains constant or irregular. See, in temperature with, see in troposphere with height, the temperature decreases. So all these is about the multiple choice question and short answer questions also. So you can do study hard and you can do your study very regularly because your examination comes soon. It may be in November month. So start your study regularly and stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mantlaka.
If you want to repeat this lecture, so you can subscribe my channel on YouTube as a Sugandha Kangar. Like it, see the video on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much.